correction, an Israeli airstrike destroyed a Hamas headquarters in Gaza, a building in which you had offices at. You received a warning in advance, but it doesn't surprise me that you shared an office with a terrorist group. It takes one to know one. Israeli Jew with Turkish and Iraqi roots, says Ido Daniel. Allah belasını versin. Köpek oğlu köpek. Hayvan oğlu hayvan. Seni Türklüğünü sikeyim. Amcı kazlı pezevenk. Allah belanı versin. Orospu çocuğu. Orospu'nun dölü.
Tweets from the IDF or about this conflict, there are like dozens of random Indian guys who profess their support for Israel. Do you have any idea why the Indians care / love Israel so publicly on Twitter? Kind of strange, lol.
It's not strange when you think about like fucking Hindu nationalists and the way that they love massacring Muslims too. Hayvan oğlu hayvan ya. Anyway,
Free Palestine, left for one free Palestine.
New released readout between Biden and fucking Benjamin Netanyahu. Yeah, I forgot to mention this. What is this? Rioters destroy small business. We can't equate the loss of life with the loss of property. This is not violence. Israel levels empty tower immediate sharing office space with Hamas. Literally the worst thing Israel's ever done. Dude, do they think that Israel is only bombing, like, buildings?
No, Leo. Eh. Napiyim, baba? Tamam.
Okay. Sorry. No one is saying that, you fuck. Yeah. This notion that like Israel has only bombed buildings and hasn't killed anyone is laughable. This notion that like Black Lives Matter protesters bombed infrastructure, like actual valuable infrastructure within the confines of a open air prison that like white people are forced to live in, where you know, Black Lives Matter literally controls their water is great. It's like equating the broken fucking storefront, you know, broken windows in the storefront to like literally bombing a school. I mean, this is the level of delusion that you have to be on to unironically defend these sorts of war crimes, because the truth does not fucking matter. Okay. The truth is not favorable to you. We have communicated directly to the Israelis, and ensuring the safety and security of journalists and independent media is a paramount responsibility. Oh, sick. You know, after they fucking bombed the media building. So that's great. That's wonderful. Let's watch the rest of this. Yeah. Yeah, if there was a fucking God, if there was a God above them, I don't know. Al Jazeera is pretty fascist, though. Okay, dude.
Support for the social.
Oh, never mind, dude.
Finland.
So, are you going to run that same energy when, like, Israeli media buildings get bombed? Are you going to just be like, well, IDF's pretty fascist, dude? Like...
My poll classes.
Is that going to be their same vibes? Are you just like, are you like, across the board, you know? Is that what your take is? You dumb fuck. Except in that circumstance, like, listen, Al Jazeera, super fucking biased when it comes to, regional conflicts that they have a stake in. State media. That's how it is. But to say that they're fascist is fucking so stupid, ridiculous. But to say that the IDF is fascist is not as stupid or ridiculous. Having said that, it would be completely unacceptable if a fucking media building was bombed by like resistance forces in Israel. That would be fucking insane. And then
it's bad when IGN is about to take the land of the free awesome AL of Bless My Envy Chat.
Wait, hold on. I just want to make sure that you don't. Bro, look at this. These motherfuckers are so used to it, dude.
It's my subversary today.
Like,
WTF is right. I just want the war crimes to stop. Can we get a break, please?
AJ English does do good coverage. Absolutely. No. Al Jazeera is great. Al Jazeera is a great outlet, with the exception of like things that pertain directly to Qatar. That's it. Like, immediately. Otherwise, Al Jazeera, AJ Plus, AJ English, like, whenever they fucking talk about, whenever they cover anything that's like outside of like immediate Qatar interest, like, they're fantastic. And especially so when you think about like their like world news coverage, it's very good. Where are LGBT people treated better, Palestine or Israel? Well, part of the reason why Palestinian lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender people aren't treated so well is because Israel keeps bombing their buildings and murdering them. So like, on the one hand, Israel is good to their own gays, but not so good to the Palestinians. So it doesn't really matter. If you think that that's a justification for like being able to bomb an entire fucking region, then I really don't know what to say to you. Like, you're a disgusting, pathetic human being who probably themselves are fucking anti-gay regardless, and just using this as an argument. Like, you are filth. You are disgusting filth. Like, I cannot believe that we are the same species, that we occupy the same space, and we breathe the same air. You are not a fucking human being, if that is your opinion. That is the justification. Like, oh, well, there's like anti-LGBT people in Palestine, so I guess we should wipe out all the LGBT people in Palestine. Disgusting, dude. Like, anyway, God, liberal, that kind of like liberal brain cancer is so fucking, it's just, you are not savable, dude. So that justification means we get to wipe out Republicans too, or fucking that, if you think that there is any like pro-gay basis to bombing Palestine, you are a delusional freak, okay? Because you're literally killing like gay Palestinians and ruining their fucking lives regardless. It's an, in, also Palestinians as a whole are pretty fucking secular, with the exception of like the fundamentalist groups that happen to control their territory because they have no other fucking option. Israelis say Hamas is human body shields. What do you say to that? I say, shut the fuck up. That is not a fucking justification, because it implies that, like, it implies that your fucking enemy, a rabid terror cell, if you want to call them that, okay, assumed or overestimated your humanity, okay? It's still a self-own. Mm.
Israel is a terrorist organization.
Like, yeah, whenever there's a hostage situation, I always want the police to come in and murder all the hostages. That's a job well done. Oh, I wanted to show this as well. It's not fair that Anne really got me. My 10-year-old says that all the time, but she's talking about not getting enough time on Roblox. This is too much for a child to be forced to bear. I don't know if this has TOS. I wanted to watch this video, but I don't know if it has TOS in it or not. Let me just scroll through it real quick. By the way, Bibi Netanyahu considers this 10-year-old girl, before we get started, also a part of Hamas propaganda. Okay. Bibi Netanyahu calls these little 10-year-old victims of fucking war crimes to be telegenic. What did he say? Telegenic children? Here, let's watch.
I'm always sick. I'm always, I don't know. I can't do anything. You all of this. What do you expect me to do? Fix it? I'm only 10. I can't even do anything in this war. I just want to be a doctor.
Oh, he said telegenically dead.
Or anything to help my people, but I can't. I'm just white pissed. I don't even know what to do. I get scared, but not really that much. I do anything for my people, but I don't know what to do. I'm just 10.
Here's the human shit.
I'm just 10. All of this, when I see, I literally cry every day, saying to myself, why do we deserve this? Why? What did we do to this? My family said they just hate us. They just don't like us because we are Muslims. Why does Muslims act for you like that? We're just kids. You see all of the kids around me? They're just kids. Why wouldn't you just send a missile to them and kill them? It's not fair.
The human shield myth debunked. You see a lot of these hoary claims of human shields in Gaza justify Israel's deliberate and indiscriminate bombardment of civilians. They use the same line in 2006 in Lebanon war and multiple wars in Gaza. Don't fall for it.
An invasion of Gaza.
Oh, what did Mehdi Hassan have a conversation around? That's interesting. Look at this fucking dude. He just looks like a shark, dude. Go get a better haircut, you fucking bitch. In 2006, Israel repeated this lie to justify killing 900 Lebanese civilians, basically treating all of South Lebanon as shielded by Hezbollah, so it's fair game. Human shielding is a specific crime. It refers to purposely using civilians to render military forces immune from attack. Taking over a family's home and not permitting the family to leave to deter the enemy from attack is a simple example of using human shields. Urban warfare, however, is not the crime shielding. In an area as densely populated as Gaza, combatants and civilians are mixed. They shouldn't be, but it's not always avoidable. Israel is not relieved from its obligation to take into account the risk of civilians simply because it considers defending party responsible for having located legitimate military targets within or near populated areas. That is, the presence of a Hamas commander or military facility in a populated area in Gaza does not justify attacking the area without regard to the threatened civilian population. Giving them warnings to leave does not give them license to attack either, straight up. So even after the warnings given, Israel must still take all feasible precautions to avoid harming civilian life and property. This includes canceling an attack when it's apparent that the target is civilian or the civilian loss will be disproportionate to expected military gain. And it's always disproportionate. They get nothing out of it. Like, they have killed a fuckload more civilians than people that they have designated as Hamas militants. And their numbers show this. It's not like the fake news UN numbers that show that more, Hamas civilians... more civilian Palestinians have died than Hamas militants. Like, it's fake news, brother. They're lying to you. You know? It's a global conspiracy. It's not that. It's IDF's own numbers that show that devastating reality. And they can get away with fucking reporting it adequately and accurately. Well, albeit still very, very, very conservative estimations. because the rest of the world can't do shit about it. They don't do shit about it. Why can't they do shit about it or don't do shit about it? Because, well, one, a lot of them have egg on their face for their own colonial and continuing, you know, neo-colonialism or imperialist roots themselves. They don't want to pay reparations for that shit, obviously. But also, two, and more significantly, America. America, both with its continued occupation, continued death and destabilization that it brings about in the entire planet, but also America is Israel's number one supporter, ally, unconditional aid across the board to the tune of $3.8 billion. That was, by the way, secured under the Obama administration. The Obama-Biden administration gave Israel $3.8 million in military aid. That's one of the last things that Obama did. But if you ask Bibi Netanyahu and some of the more rabid fucking psychopathic reactionary Israelis and supporters of Israel, Obama was the most anti-Semitic administration of all time. $3.8 billion a year. That's what they fucking get. Anyway. For example, for a real example of human shielding, see this case of IDF forces using a Palestinian boy as a human shield when they attacked the Palestinian home. Israel's number one defense for hundreds of Gazans it killed in 2008 and 9 war was human shielding, but an investigation after investigation, the Human Rights Watch found no evidence, not in deaths caused by white phosphorus, not in attacks on civilians waving white flags. It offered up the same human shielding claim to treat all of Gaza as terrorists and indiscriminately bombarded territory in 2014. Again, time after time after time, the Human Rights Watch disputed the claims that human shielding was occurring in Gaza. For the record, okay? In an area as densely populated as the Gaza Strip, where civilians have absolutely nowhere to fucking go, and that is literally the design of the Israeli occupying force, by the way, in that circumstance, the qualifications are never there to bomb a civilian building, okay? It's never like human shielding. Okay. Are the new numbers 2.4? Like more than 2 million Gazans exist in this incredibly densely occupied territory. Okay. All right, let's hear what...
Even 500 Palestinian children were killed in the 2014 Gaza war, according to both the UN and human rights groups. How worried should we be tonight that Israel is about to launch another full-scale assault, maybe an invasion of Gaza?
Thank you, Mehdi, for inviting me. I think the question you're asking is something to refer to Hamas spokespeople, because eventually the reality on the ground is that quiet will be responded by quiet. If Hamas is going to continue threatening Israeli civilians... firing rockets indiscriminately towards Israeli towns, then we're going to be forced to respond and respond forcefully. And by the way, this is not just Israel. Any country in the world would have done the same if their cities were attacked under constant attack.
Nah, dude, everyone would be just like psychopathic, genocidal, bloodthirsty freaks. And he is kind of right. America would certainly be just as psychopathic and just as fucking bloodthirsty. America has been that way for a very long time. That doesn't make it right, though. That actually still is wrong. The other countries are wrong, and so is Israel. It's fucking insane.
By rockets, by terrorist organizations.
I mean, any country in the world, most countries in the world are not in charge of a decades-long military occupation. But you mentioned Hamas rocket strikes. I think we can both agree that Hamas firing rockets at civilian buildings is wrong. Can we both agree on that? I think we can agree on that, right? That's common ground for us.
Hamas firing rockets at civilian population.
He's literally... Okay, so Mehdi is about to trap him. So he's going to say Hamas... He's going to trap him. He's going to say, so Hamas firing rockets on civilian buildings is wrong. So why is it okay when Israel does it? He doesn't even understand it. At first, he thinks, like, I'm talking to Mehdi Hassan. Like, obviously, he's going to be fucking pro-Palestinian. So he originally thought... He misunderstood originally what he said, so he's doing a double take. probably doesn't recognize that he's walking into
a
trap.
Wrong. There is fully agreement with us on that.
Agreed. You got me on. We're 100%. We agree. And yet today you had a 13-story residential apartment building in Gaza targeted by the Israeli Air Force destroyed. How is that not anything other than a war crime, a deliberate attack on a civilian target?
You know, I think it's actually very disfortunate that people are trying to equate the IDF response to Hamas as a terrorist organization.
Well, you can't really equate that, actually, can you? Because the IDF is significantly better at doing terror than Hamas is. Let's be fucking real. If bombing civilian buildings is terrorism, then Hamas is like baby terrorists, okay? They're fucking little babies in comparison to the death and devastation and terrorism that the IDF does and subjects Palestinian people to on a daily fucking basis. Hamas are fucking noobs, dude. They're noobs. They have nothing.
Organization. Israel acts in accordance to the international law.
Let me tell you something. And this is something you usually hear from some of the more rabid fucking defenders of this brutality. They'll literally say, sorry, if it's a genocide and Israel is as all-powerful as you say it is, why haven't they just wiped out Hamas? Or they'll say, Israel is so powerful, they could just, like, wipe out the entirety of the fucking Gaza Strip if it was really a genocide. Okay? So you are admitting it. You're admitting that Israel is significantly more powerful than Hamas then. And yet, instead of fucking taking measures that are more calculated, okay, and trying to mitigate the fucking damage, you still end up blowing the fuck out of civilian buildings. Got it.
We target only Hamas targets, and every target that we're...
Because all genocides completely wipe out the population? Yeah, that's a really funny one. That's a really ironic one that a Jewish person is saying, by the way, considering the fucking fact that, like, you know, a Holocaust did happen to Jews. And, you know, obviously everyone didn't get fucking wiped out. So it's ridiculous. Like, so ridiculous. And that's literally how the Nazis justified it back then. And that's how the Nazis straight up fucking try to do Holocaust denial right now.
Firing at. Is being chosen very carefully. We do that with accordance of international law in order to minimize civilian casualties and collateral damage. And you know what? We're the only country and the only organization, the only ones in the Middle East that actually care about international law. Hamas doesn't care.
Israel cares about international law as far as it can avoid it, okay? It's like when fucking Joe Biden says, like, know the science behind climate change, and then we're going to still do fracking. You're saying, like, oh, no, we care about international law, but, like, we read up on it so we can, you know, completely fucking never, ever pay attention to it at all.
Palestinian Islamic Jihad doesn't care, and every loss of life
but
is
Elad,
unfortunate.
16 you flattened, I mean, we don't have time to get into an argument about international law. Suffice to say that most human rights groups criticize Israel for violating human rights law, and they criticize Hamas.
Whoa, hold on. It's coming. You got the anti-Semitism button ready, I hope, because I'm about to hit it, boys. Most international rights groups, I can't believe they criticize Israel. It's because they're fucking anti-Semitic. Guess what? Why aren't they criticizing China? Guess what? Why aren't they criticizing Saudi Arabia for what's going... Actually, he won't mention Saudi Arabia because Saudi Arabia is a valuable ally to Israel. But, like, guess what? So many other atrocities are occurring. Why do the international rights and NGOs never, ever criticize any of these other countries? Whataboutism? After he hits the anti-Semitism button, he's going to hit the fucking whataboutism button.
But you leveled an apartment building. I think you gave him a one-hour warning to get out of the building. Do you think that's in line with humanitarian law to bomb a civilian apartment building in Gaza?
You know, Hamas is using the Palestinians in Gaza as human shields. They're firing rockets at Israel from within centers of civilian population because they want to see these sites. They want to force Israel to respond and to see these sites. Now, also...
Well, then don't do it. I mean, easy way, dude. Like, dude, this is so dehumanizing. Like, having this conversation over and over again is so disgusting. Like, imagine being a fucking Palestinian person, okay? And you're just stuck in this, like, little fucking open-air prison, okay? And then they talk about your, like, you're not a human in their eyes. Like, you are so not a human that the worst consequence of your fucking school getting bombed, okay, or your mother being killed on her way from the fucking market back home is how bad it makes Israel look, dude. Like, can you imagine just with a straight face being like, yeah, it's kind of sucks. It's kind of shitty that, like, you know, kids are dying or whatever. But, like, the real problem is how bad it makes us look. And Hamas knows this. And that's why, like, you know, we just can't stop ourselves from bombing. But, you know, we just have to bomb. Sorry. You're denying my right to bomb. It's kind of fucked up. And the worst part about this entire process is that it just makes me look bad in the eyes of the international community.
So Hamas and the Palestinian authorities are exaggerating with the numbers. You were mentioning earlier in your show about the casualties and the children that were killed.
Yeah, they're exaggerating the numbers. It wasn't a 13-story building as reported. It was actually a 12-story building. And the 13 children that died, well, one of them actually looked kind of like an adult. Okay, so maybe we should just put that in the adult category, okay? You know, I know we killed 13 children, but one of them did look very old, okay? So let's just say 13-year-old man for that 13-year-old. I mean, 13, I mean, you're basically a man at that point. I mean, you're crazy. If you can hold up a, if you can, you know, if you've gotten past, like, regular basic algebra, oh, wait, you can't because we bombed your school. Fuck. I mean, you're a 13-year-old man, though. Come on, think about it.
Killed, and you said that it was results of IDF strikes, but yeah. We know for a fact that six of these children, for example, were killed because of Hamas rockets were misfired and fell in within okay. Gaza Strip, well, and they killed the Palestinians.
Okay, I love this take. It's like, dude, do you give, like, oh, Hamas rockets misfired and fell into the Gaza Strip, like, and they actually killed, first of all, it's not even true. Secondly, like, that, again, is a testament to how little power Hamas has and how little of a threat Hamas is, if it's true, okay? So it certainly is not a fucking, it's not a supporting factor in your side, okay? You can't literally be like, Hamas is both so weak that they are literally killing their own citizens on accident and that, like, our Iron Dome is so powerful and it fucking stops everything, but also they're so powerful that it justifies literally wiping out entire city blocks with some of the most powerful weaponry that this world has ever seen.
So I'm taking any report
just
coming
to,
from
just to be clear. I just want to be clear here, Elad. I just want us to be clear. Let's find common ground. Are we now saying, is your position, because I'm sure militant groups are listening in from across the world, is your position that apartment buildings are fair game if there's someone inside you don't like it?
Yes, Hamas rockets are literally so dog shit, for the record, that some of them do fall into the Gaza territory. So far, none of them, if from what I've read, at least, so far, none of them have fucking killed. so far, none of them have killed Palestinians. It's like fucking fireworks. Like, they're shooting it out of. How do I describe it? They're shooting it. Soba borusunu İngilizce söyleyeceğim. Rockets are fireworks, yes, but there's a difference between, like, fucking straight actual rockets and, like, the dumbass fucking little fireworks that you use. None of them killed Palestinians? Copium? Are you talking to me? Are you saying that, like, none of the fucking Palestinians are secular copium? Looks like God doesn't care about his holy land. Dodging the question. Easy clap. Communist. Yep. Runs an ad every hour. Yep. Millionaire communist. Feels okay, man. Yep. I don't know. Seems kind of hypocritical. Feels okay, man. Yes. Communism is when you don't work for a capitalist enterprise under an international capitalist organization of the economy.
Hassle.
It's when you fucking starve in the streets. You're right. Thank you. Yeah. Stovepipe. That's the word, what I was looking for. They, like, launch shit out of stovepipes, dude. Yeah. Communism is when poverty, dude. Communism is when homeless. Thank you. Dude, brilliant minds, by the way. God, I can't... I just... Some of the greatest minds are in opposition to the things I'm saying.
...were misfired and fell in within okay. Gaza Strip, well, and they killed the Palestinians. So I'm taking any report
just
coming
to,
from
just to be clear. I just want to be clear here, Elad. I just want us to be clear. Let's find common ground. Are we now saying, is your position, because I'm sure militant groups are listening in from across the world, is your position that apartment buildings are fair game if there's someone inside you don't like? Is that the position of the Israeli government tonight?
You know, you say that you don't want to go into international law, but the question that you're asking is exactly a question of international law. It's a question of what is a legitimate target.
It's a simple question. Are apartment buildings okay to bomb? Because I'm sure Hamas will say that.
If it's a military target, then it's a legitimate strike. If Hamas is using the target in order to hide weapons, in order to use it as a commanding...
So, what's up, dude? Literally every fucking Israeli... is at some point a member of the IDF and they're in reserves and shit. So doesn't that literally open up the door for Hamas to be like, yeah, we'll fucking, of course we're gonna fire rockets at all different parts of Israel, because, you know, there's just fucking every Israeli at some point is like serving the fucking military and shit. Like, that's crazy. Like, that's you're literally allowing Hamas to just like justify their actions. Only 50% go, but fine. Okay, 50%. Sorry.
A post.
Okay,
then
so,
it's a legitimate strike. But you said you don't want to go there, so...
So... Okay, I mean, it was an apartment building with hundreds of families, and you told them to leave, so you knew there were families in there.
So if Hamas is using human shields, we have no choice but to murder the innocent human shields. Sorry, wish there was another way. Yeah, that's all it is. That's all it is. At the end, that's literally all it is, dude. There is nothing other than that. That is just the only fucking thing that they're saying. It's crazy. It's absolute fucking madness that they just say that. And people just, like, eat that shit up. The fucking blind hatred that so many people feel towards Muslims that like, allows them to turn a blind eye to this or, like, even justify it, it blows my fucking mind, dude. Yeah, 40 children have died since Monday, by the way. Israel's bombardment in Gaza continued for a fifth consecutive day as of May 15th, and with Israeli air raids hitting a refugee camp where several Palestinians, including children, were killed. At least 139 Palestinians, including 40 children, have been killed in the Gaza Strip since Monday. 11 Palestinians have also been killed by Israeli forces in the occupied West Bank. Hundreds of people have gathered in the Australian city of Melbourne to express their solidarity with the Palestinians. There are demonstrations that are occurring all around the world, by the way. A two-month-old Palestinian boy was pulled alive from under the rubble while seven other family members perished at the Al-Shifa hospital after an Israeli airstrike struck the Al-Shati refugee camp without advance warning during the night. Funerals are currently being held in the occupied West Bank city of Nablus for Palestinian protesters killed on Friday by Israeli forces. Like, literally, they're fucking bombing refugee camps. But Hamas, bro. I mean, sorry, Hamas, bro. Egypt has sent 10 ambulances to Gaza to pick up casualties of Israeli bombardments for treatment in Egyptian hospitals. Hundreds of Palestinian demonstrators are facing off with Israeli troops who shot and killed at least 11 in the occupied bank, by the way. So there is that part of the process as well. So they're fucking murdering. Yeah, I know. I'm going to show the brutally beaten woman protester in Sheikh Jarrah. Just to look, some of these are incredibly fucking hard to see. Okay, these are not easy to look at. But you have to see it. You have to see the fucking brutality. Okay. Here you go. Here's some more. And now I'm going to show you this is what's going on in the Sheikh Jarrah neighborhood in Jerusalem, in occupied Jerusalem. Here it is. Look at that, bro. Come on. Dude, I mean, but guys, they're fucking gay and vegan, dude. Like, I mean, they're gay and vegan. Also, Hamas. Not in the fucking West Bank, but still. Hamas. I just keep saying Hamas over and over again, and maybe it'll stick. How is what Israel is doing any different from Obama when he would claim it is a collateral damage when nuking civilians if they live with a person Obama didn't like? Are we going to see you rep Israeli merch soon, or does Obama get the only pass? Yes, Obama gets the only pass. Yeah. Yeah. Because you know I'm a big fan of Obama and, like, have never called him a war criminal, so that's true. Yeah, I'm glad that you really caught on to that. Because everybody knows I've always been a supporter of Obama, and not only that, but, like, also fucking advocate for Obama. Hard body. Remember when I literally said, like, 15 to 30 minutes ago that, like, Obama is literally responsible for a lot of this fucking bloodshed by one of his last moves getting out of office was to give Israel $3.8 billion a year for the next 10 years? Remember when I just said that? And that is before we talk about all the other horrific acts of cruelty that Obama has been the commander in chief over and oversaw. Like, that chatter, yeah, I was just about to say, like, do you not know how people view me as? Like, are you really going to come in here? Like, go back to fucking 8/21/2019. Anyway. What's the solution? Widespread international condemnation. America literally fucking taking every Jack ounce of fucking aid from Israel with the Twitch condition that they stop their occupation in the West Bank, open up the Gaza Strip, and start immediate renovations for all the damages.
Why did that guy call you a millionaire communist? What's your views on millionaires making all this money while people are starving to death?
What? I'm not going to do a fucking theory stream right now to try to describe to you that, like, not even communism, but Marxism has nothing to do with, like, balance beyond giving the means of production back to workers, and that it's literally not about, like, your income level, but rather how you generate that income. It's too long and you're not going to listen. You just think that it's a good own, and that's why you're bringing it up. But thank you for giving me money to say so. Dude, I'm in the process of describing what Israel should do, and then people literally in between that we'll go, what do you want Israel to do? Genuine question. Motherfucker, you're not listening to the genuine question. Like, did you just click on the stream? Like, just now? Can you make a YouTube video for that and just link whenever someone asks? I have.
Square root of 674,041.
What the fuck is this? What are you? Pictures from a doctor I received in Rauf Fidia Hospital. The type of bullets used to cause organs to explode and break up. The docs are not able to determine the type. Completely control is difficult. The goal is clear. And it's only killing. Dude, why would you think I can watch that, dude? Are you crazy? On stream. The mind of someone looking for a way to weasel both sides, some both sides out of this shit. Yeah. Okay. All right. We already watched a 10-year-old Palestinian. French police crackdown on protesters. Yeah. There was a protest in Paris for Palestine, and it was met with water cannons and tear gas. I think that the principles of liberty, egalite, and fraternity are only demonstrated in the liberal safe haven of France up to a certain point, and that point is if you're Muslim, then fuck you. And as you know, well, a lot of Palestinians are Muslim, so I don't think that the Emmanuel Macron regime is ever going to allow that kind of shit to occur. It's being like anti-Islam and anti-Muslim is kind of like, it's kind of the only way that some of these French politicians see themselves winning any election now at this point. Family moving to your apartment. After a while, you were only allowed to live in the closet. Enjoy. Oh, yeah, you still pay for the rent? Yeah, that's what Israel's doing. I think that's what you're talking about, right? The UAE has threatened Hamas that they will stop investments if they don't stop bombing Israel. UAE has also called out Hamas when a delegation went to Gaza to check up on a hospital they built and saw that they were operating rocket launchers from there shooting at the IAF. The UAE are fucking lapdogs for Western imperialism. Not the people, but the fucking administrations are fucking dogs. Do you understand me? Their worth is less than the dog shit that I step that gets stuck in the crevices in the bottom of my shoe. Let me make one thing clear. All of those Gulf nation leaders can rot, okay? They are fucking cowardly dogs, and they always have been, and they will continue to be. They will do anything to suckle on the American Western imperialist teat. I do not give a single shred of a fuck about what they have to say, okay? It does not matter. They are, one, they literally use slave labor, so it's kind of funny that you're, you know, doing this shit. Oh my God, dude. Imagine using that. Imagine using the fucking opinion of Gulf nation leaders as a justification. They are fucking dogs, dude. Literally, dogs. And most people that live in that region, unless they themselves are fucking gigantic pieces of shit, will also agree with me. Their entire existence and America's allegiance with these nations is built upon the most hypocritical foundation. The justifications America uses, and you psychopathic weirdos in the chat always fucking parrot like, oh, these are not LGBT friendly places, so we should glass them and shit like that, literally exist in all of these nations that you're talking about. Sometimes in a way worse capacity. Like you're like, oh, Iran, we need to fucking Iran. Well, we need to bomb Iran, dude. There's like, they're so anti-LGBT. They're so anti-LGBT. Okay, what about fucking literally Saudi Arabia, dude? They are the worst. Okay, the worst of the worst. I hate them so much. Thank you, Rapid White, for the 50 gifted subs. Shouldn't the stored Hamas rockets explode and create a mess of successive random explosions or launches spanning minutes and knocking out the surroundings? I don't know how that works, to be honest. There was a ceasefire for many years, and Israel continued to beat the Palestinians mercilessly beyond a point of submission. Okay? Even then, Palestinians were like, well, what the fuck are we supposed to do? We can't do anything. And the bombing campaign started on the Hamas side.
I love your streams.
With very reasonable conditions. Hamas is not reasonable. Okay? Otherwise, like, yes, there are actual fucking anti-Semites in within the organization. Yes, some of them say psychotic things like fucking kill all the Jews, blah, blah, blah. Obviously. Okay? But their take leading up to this last, like, bombing campaign where they launched rockets into Israel came with an unironic warning where they actually fucking straight up said, stop the occupation in the Al-Aqsa Mosque and allow Palestinians freedom of travel to go into the mosque to be able to pray during Ramadan, and put a moratorium on the threat of eviction of Palestinians living in the occupied territories, specifically the six families that are currently facing eviction right now. Okay? In Sheikh Jarrah. That is straight up a fucking reasonable take. That is, I'm sorry, if you don't think that that is reasonable, you're a fucking psychopath. It should not even be brought up. That should have never even become a point of contention, because Israel should have never done the things that they did. The IDF should have never done the things that they did at the Al-Aqsa Mosque. Expulsion, not eviction. You're right. You're correct. I'm just, you know, sometimes I end up accidentally using colonizer terms when describing the situation. That's literally just, that's a that is once again, very terrible take. Please go back to streaming terrible gameplay content. I'm sorry that it offends your sensibilities that robs you of the comfortable bubble that you exist in, where you can continue justifying inhumane actions against all Palestinians. I apologize. It doesn't feel good when you're like, oh, fuck, the other side is just like, you know, actual fucking humans. Saying that to a political streamer also is hilarious. But thank you.
I love her content. Thanks for making politics so palpable and easier to understand, Chad. Sorry if off topic, but is the nicotine gum you're chewing? Been trying to.
How easy is it to leave the region as a Palestinian? It's not easy. And also, they shouldn't leave anyway. What the fuck do you mean? Where do they go when they leave, brother? What the fuck? Just leave your. Man, just leave your fucking home, dude, and your family behind. What is this? What stage of capitalism is this? What the fuck? Jesus, Lord mercy. Holy fucking shit, dude. We have deep, deep rooted problems, boys, that I'm not afraid. I'm not sure we will be able to solve anytime soon, okay? Anyway, I'm going to run another ad break here. This is a good spot to just, like, run a quick one. Yair Netanyahu had a good take. I'm going to show you that. But it's a good spot to also showcase how capitalism has penetrated our lives and our wonderful little bubble of the internet. If you'd like to no longer see those ads, of course, you can subscribe for $5 or for free by connecting your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account and getting one free Twitch Prime a month. Here's the ad break now.
At Hassan Abi Pepela.
Have you seen the idea of propaganda going viral on TikTok? What is this? If I lose any blood on the way to salvation. What? Oh yeah. If I lose any blood on the way to salvation. Israel always win. Fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up. We've talked about this before. Like, dude, sexy IDF soldiers is like primo IDF propaganda.
No. Oh. Öyle mi? Dur derim.
Söylerim, tamam. My dad just got sprayed by the sprinkler system, which is not supposed to open up in the middle of the day. Sorry. IGN Switzerland announces they're staying neutral battle between free IGN Palestine, America and IGN
Palestine,
Israel.
Free Palestine, free Palestine, free Palestine, free Palestine, free Palestine, free Palestine.
Hamas is just as much responsible for the current conflict that's happening, dude. Same as Israel, if not more. Yeah. Like when, you know, when the occupation began, originally, or when the battle lines were drawn and mass immigration started occurring into Palestine and Palestinian region by Jewish people of all backgrounds from the entire world, it was actually Hamas, a terror cell, an Islamist fundamentalist militant organization dedicated to the liberation of Palestinian people that was formed in 1987. They were responsible for it, you know, fucking 40 years before. It's crazy that they were literally just like, they have a bunch of future thinkers in Hamas. That's why they're so dangerous. It's crazy that Hamas actually has time travel powers. God damn, dude. Gaslight, gatekeep, girl boss, baby. Let's go. Fuck me, dude. Holy shit. I mean, look, just like I don't deny that, like, hot tub streamers are still engaging in, like, lewd entry point erotica, which is still ultimately not damaging in any way, I have to also admit that these IDF ladies are fucking hot, okay? They're bloodthirsty, genocidal psychos who not only directly are responsible for bloodshed and have blood, the blood of Palestinians in their hands, but also continue to justify an inhumane occupation. But also on the other hand, it's like they're kind of attractive. So I have to admit it. It doesn't fucking change it. Bruh, men are weak as fuck. Yes, this is true. But it is, but remember, this is like deliberate. This is not fucking, I just need you to understand, this is on purpose. Like, this is propaganda. Like, they're fucking hot, bro. Come on, bro. Come on, join the IDF. Or they're hot, dude. Come on. But like, how can hot people do bad things? They don't do bad things. Just fucking shut up and coomer. Okay? Are men okay? Baby, let me see it. I just wanna eat it. Baby, let me see it. Oh, I really need it. Oh, baby, let me see it. I just wanna. Eze ke payomu agua. Eze ke payomu agua. Wadama se. Hayav makot chasmal eli ze lo kore lecha shuv. Daimi. Bro, whenever they make like references to murder, I'm literally thinking like, well, I mean, you're kind of doing that. Like, you know what I mean? Like, whenever they fucking make references to like murder or like, what are you telling me? I should kill everybody. I'm like, fuck, dude. I mean, you kind of are doing that. Like, why are you? Oh, God. The inherent message being not only are war crimes fun, but they make you fun and flirty. Yeah, I get that. Yes. You just successfully made chat pro-Israel now? Okay, shut up, dude. Like, we're fucking joking about this shit, but, like, there is a lot of this that goes on, you know? Draco. Soldier. She make it clap, clap, clap. She make it clap, clap, clap. She make it. Everybody can tell me you are so primitive. You can tell me whatever you want. I don't care. אני יודעת, הוא לא הולך לעשות כלום וזה וזה וזה וכל יפה, אני יודעת, אבל אני... Intifada season 4 incoming, Kekwait.
What the fuck is this? Jesus Christ, dude.
Okay, stop showing me other hot IDF chicks, dude. What the fuck is wrong with you? Don't do this. Okay. Also, another fucking hot take from friend of the show, Andre. Just fucking abolish celebrities already. Aisha Curry took the IDF propaganda and posted it on her fucking profile, dude. Yo, it's additionally weird that, like, a group of people that have been fucking... That have been colonized... For so many fucking centuries to just like turn around and like take the colonizer propaganda hook, line, and sinker, dude. That shit is crazy to me. It blows my mind. I was one girl's personal TikTok channel. Israeli propaganda. You must be trolling. Yeah.
Propaganda is when a brash person gets a good look at something.
Yeah, dude. That idea of using like hot soldiers to justify fucking girl boss genocide is certainly not something that the IDF does personally. Okay, that has never happened. Let's watch some IDF ads actually that range from look how sexy we are to look how vegan we are because we place the lives of animals over the lives of Palestinian humans because we don't think Palestinians are humans. They're not even animals. You know, there's a look how LGBT we are. There's this one is straight up IDF.
Happy Saturday.
Literally Gal Gadot's job before and after Wonder Woman. Anyway. What Israeli gays are posting?